Our people are on the march. In their tens of thousands. A great democratic, popular people's crusade to bring the truth before the people. They'll have to be blind, deaf, and dumb, all three, not to understand before this referendum is held. I guarantee that right now. All three together, blind, deaf, and dumb, not to understand what Confederation means between now and the referendum. The people, Lord, the people, not thrones and crowns and merchants, but men. God, save the people. Save them from bondage and despair. God, save the people.
He began to sound like a young messiah come out of the desert, you know, to lead the flock somewhere or they're not so sure where. But he was the
Wick
young messiah.
Wick Collins, now an editorial writer, was a leader in the fight against Confederation.
He had been a radio broadcaster. There was a certain appeal in his approach. So it was centered around his personality. Everything they did in publicity-wise was a lot smarter, a lot slicker, a lot shrewder than that put out by the Responsible Government League. Ours was inclined to be sort of rather like heavy statements or pronouncements from the establishment. It was almost like the voice of God ringing down in some ways, you know.
Brave Newfoundlanders who plow the salt sea, with hearts like the eagle, so bold and so free. The time is at hand when you'll all have to say if Confederation will carry the day.
Smallwood's newspaper, for instance, they would publish a cartoon about responsible government, showing responsible government as the source of all want and misery and corruption and graft and undernourishment and impoverished children in the background and God knows what.
I didn't have the advantage of television. I had only radio, but at that time no one had television, and the entire population of Newfoundland listen to me, and I was well known. My voice was well known. My name was.
How important is that? Rennie Levesque, as well as being the premier, built his reputation as a broadcaster, as a communicator.
Well, I think that that in politics of any kind, radio and television, especially television, is a sheer miracle. It's absolute miracle. But Rennie is not the only one who can go on TV. There are others who can do that.
Well, I think I don't know. I say that Levesque could win. But his chances are slim, very, very slim. But with the right campaign and the wrong reactions from English Canada, he could win. It's going to be largely dependent on the reactions in English Canada.
They have the people of Canada who are in Quebec and in all the other nine provinces have a great part to play, and the part they have to play is to show that they regard the Canadians in Quebec who are of French descent and language and race and culture as their brothers, brother Canadians. That's not too heavy a price for us non-French Canadians to pay for the preservation of a great and beautiful land, is it?
But I don't think you're ever going to sell Quebec to English Canada, my feeling. You might sell it in the odd patch of it here and there, but the general feeling I have is that I think it's gone now beyond the stage where you can sell Quebec to English Canada.
So how can you sell English Canada to Quebec?
Well, this is going to be part of the thing. This is what makes it good for Rennie Levesque, doesn't it? It makes it easier for Rennie Levesque.
They won't be divided. The Federalists will not be divided. They'll be one mighty and influential and capable and clever and sincere movement with just as much emotion and just as much sentiment as on the other side. More, in fact. Surely you can be much more emotional about and appeal and arouse emotions much more on an issue of preserving the unity of a great and lovely nation than in breaking it up. Surely all the logic and the sense and the practicality and the sentiment and the emotion will be in favor of keeping Canada going as a nation.
But your opponents were able to talk about the importance of keeping Newfoundland as a nation, all the same
yes.
arguments, and they lost.
And they lost because they kept pointing out that keeping Newfoundland separate meant hunger, it meant starvation, it meant unemployment, it meant trying to paddle our own canoe, trying to get along by our own unaided efforts. This we had never been able to do. And in this modern world, post-war world, with the fierce competition and struggle for existence and rivalry, we'd be lost, completely lost. Whereas here was a great country, Canada, which had helped to win the war, which had lent Britain thousands of millions, up in the billions of dollars, and had played a very great part in a world war. Here was a great nation that would be happy to have us and proud to have us.
Our home and native land, true patriot love, which all our sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north, strong and free. We stand on guard, O Canada.